Alrighty, guys.
Here we are. I'm going to make some arrows today for a little fella that's been pestering me. He wants them by tomorrow morning because we've got a QRE down at Pennant Hills. We'll just have a look here. He's got X-Buster 500s, Carbon Express. Have a look at them. They look pretty fat to me. They're fat. Alright, they're fat and hollow. Look at them. Whee, alright. So he's got the CXL pin knocks, but they actually came with it, so he's ended up with two sets of them. They're the ones that came with it. And he's got collars on there. He wants collar protection. There's his fat points, 120 grain points. He loves black fletching. He's got tiny little pin knocks right there. Not sure what brand they are. There they are. Nice little pin knocks. So as you can see, I got the camera set up here. That's not focusing again. There it is. So I'm going to put the camera on here. What I do is I do all my work on a newspaper, and then I can just, when it gets too dirty or whatever, I can just fold that up and throw it away. Got the air conditioning on, need that. Got the cricket in the background, that's essential. And that's about it. So first thing we're going to do with these is find out which, we're going to find out the side of these that is the weaker spine, because he demanded that as well in his setup. So we're going to find the weaker spine, make the mark so we know where to put the veins on. Then we're going to put the collars, pin knocks and knocks on. We'll fletch them. Then we'll weigh what we've got, what we've made with the points, and we'll put the lightest point on the heaviest arrow to get close to the same weight. So here we go. I'll just stop now and I'll get set up for testing the spine. Okay, step one, I don't need to go and put them in the bath and float them. That's another factoid that I've done on how to find the weak part of the spine on a shaft by floating them in a body of water. But we don't need to, what I've found is that the stiffer the arrow, the less this way works, by just compressing the arrow down. A very stiff arrow, you can't do it, you've got to go and do it in the water, but these are only 500s. I mean, yeah, I could snap that with very little effort at all. So I've just put a point in each end. I'm going to put that down there, and I've just made a small little hole for that to just seat into, and then when I push this down equally, it will turn, and I can see where that weak spot is. I'm going to turn it a little bit that way, and it's a repeatable result. So then I mark it with the arrow, I mark it with the pen where I see that, where I see it flex in. So it's the same every time, and it's right there. So there's my first one. You can see that there. Is that it's going to focus on that spot. You can just see the mark I make here, and that shows me the weak side. That shows me the weak side of this shaft. So that one's done. So I take the points out of that, and that's easier said than done. As professional, that one's done. We'll just do one more. So you get the idea. So I put the point in that end, put the point in that end, place it onto the carpet where it won't move, line that hole up there, give it an even push and see where it flexes. Now I like to do that and then turn the arrow a little bit to see if it still goes to that spot. And it does, it's just in here like this, so that one's there. I make the mark. and that mark is there, right on here, and I'll just do that with all 12 arrows, all 12 shafts, and then we can start putting the pins and knocks in. All right, so I'll just do the rest and we'll get back to the next bit. Don't forget to check out my little video on finding the weaker side of the shaft in water. It was very exciting. It was about 44 degrees that day. Very hot. Okay, you can see here now that every one of these has marked the weak side of the spine. See the marks on each one of these shafts. So now what I'm going to do is put the collars on like this. This one's here. If you can see that, we'll just get that. So they're going to have a collar on them and we're going to put glue a pin in. So I'm going to show you how I glue the pins in right now. So you never want to heat up the carbon at all. So even when you take points out or pins out, it's better to put them in boiling water than it is to put a flame to it. So the idea is that if you hang on to the item that you're going to put into the shaft, whether it's a point like this or the pin knock like that, you should be able to hold it the whole time you heat it up, glue it, reheat it and stick it in. If it gets too hot to hold, it's too hot. It doesn't need to be with this blue glue that I'm using here. So the problem is, though, because the pin knock's so small, you really do need to hold the pin knock like that, but I'll hold the points by the tip, and that tells me how hot it's getting. But I won't overheat it. I'll apply it to, if you can see the flame here, I'll apply it to the flame a little bit to heat it up. Then I'll heat up the glue, I'll wipe the glue on there, I'll give the glue a little bit more of a heating, and then I'll slip it in. Easy as that. So we're going to do that now. Turn on the fire. Bingo. We've got our first one. Oh, no, stop. Actually, stop. I've really got to put all the collars on first, so I'll do that now. The collars just fit on like this. Slipped over the top. So I'm going to put all the collars on first. I like to do everything in a set way and then move to the next thing and do all 12 the next way instead of fiddling around going forward and backward. So I'll just be back within a second and I'll have all the collars on, and then I'll show you how to glue the points in, and we'll go from there. Okay, there they are. All the knocks are on. So I'm just now going to show you how to put one pin knock in. Just get that there like that. Stand. To borrow it off James. Right, so watch. So turn this on. Go over pin knock. Now I'm not heating these up, just giving it a little bit. The hottest part of the flame is the tip of the blue in the center. That's enough. Give this a bit of a melt. Apply that around like that. That's enough there. Now I just give that, I just heat that up a little bit under the thing there and just slip that in, spin it over and push it down like that. Now this residue here, you've got two choices. You can wipe it off like this beforehand, before it dries. You can wipe it on the just wipe it off like this, just spin it around and wipe it off, or you can leave it. You can leave it and just cut it off with a knife. And I like to get all the blue off so it looks nice. You know, what presentation is everything. So that's one done. I'll just do one more for you so you can watch that. So we put that in there, grab the glue, heat that up a little bit. Just make sure it's around the side, all around, like that. Ooh. These are real fat ones, these ones. Just give that a bit of a heating up there. Grab the next one, stick it in. That's in. Give it a push, and there you have it. I could wipe that off right now like that. And there you have it. Can you see that? Let's have a look. See, I've wiped that off while it's still wet onto here. You can see that there where I've just wiped it off. And we're ready to go. Okay. All right, so I'm going to do the rest and we'll get back to you. The next thing will be to put the knocks on after I've got all the pins in. All right. Ciao. All righty, guys. So, all the pins are in. Looking pretty clean, and all I did was wipe them. You can see where I wiped each one. I just put it on there like that, and I just turned that around, spun it around, and just got all that excess off. So they're in there beautifully. Now, the next thing to do is whack these pin knocks on. That's not too hard, but I'll just do it in front of you in case you're completely confused. All right. So the idea is here that we've got a collar on the carbon shaft to protect it and keep it tight together, but we've got a pin knock here with this part here that's going to protect it against a point coming in, smashing your knock. It'll hit the pin, wreck the pin. You've got to replace that, but it'll hit here and bounce off, and that collar's there as a secondary protection, and that's going to protect the back of your arrow, which is what you want, because if you're, you know, spending $40 on an arrow, you want it protected. As with mine here, these are my 300s that I'm making. You can see I've done the same thing. I've got a pin and a gold collar, silver pin, into a knock there. What's the name of those knocks? They're AccuKnox, meant to be unbreakable. I've smashed them to pieces. In fact, these blue ones here, 8 of them cracked. Before I haven't even shot one of these yet, and I've got 8 cracked knocks already on those, so I'm sending them back. I'm a master of the send back. All right. So whack these knocks on. Just down here, let's have, oh, show you. Oh! Hang on. Okay, so get these. Get these knocks out. Goodness knows what kind they are. He'd know. Now it doesn't matter which way I put them on at first. I'm just gonna push them on like that. And later on, I'm gonna have to line this knock up with the mark that I've made so that the top fletch, the top vein, will go there like that, in line with that. It looks like he's using Fletch Flex veins, which are meant to be pretty good, pretty strong. Flex Fletch veins. I'm just trying them out on those ones that I showed you just then of mine, these ones here. These are Flex Fletch veins, and I'm hoping that they will recover, because I tell you what, look at that. That was a pass-through. Look what it did. It's a shocker. And I find that these veins, these VeinTech veins, they don't come back. They don't come back after they've been hit. But I saw Scotty Bryce using these ones, and after a pass-through, they were all crinkled. By the time he got back to the line again to shoot, they were back to normal again. So I think I'm going to try these Flex Fletch, and obviously the young fella here, he's opted to go for the FLP 400s, which is what I use in indoor. So I think he's looking at using these for indoor, but also trying to bust some lines in target archery as well. He's going to use them tomorrow at a QRE at 50 metres. And I think he's hoping to up his score. He wants to get into the Australian team, so he needs a couple of good shoots. All right, so there we go. They're all done. Now I'm going to go through how to fletch these. So there we go. So fletching is next. Now the most important thing about fletching, well, the first thing is to line up your fletch when you put it in the jig with the mark on there. So my first vein will be in line with that. Now he hasn't got a cock. He hasn't got a different colour, so he's got to be aware of knocking this properly when he puts it in the bow, so that this is on top, because it'll flex upward as it's shot out. It will flex up like that. Shoot down and flex up. They'll all go the same way. Consistent departure from the arrow. All right, so I'm just going to set up the jig. The Bitzenberg jig to do these, and I'll show you how that's done. And especially using the glue, because the problem was that you see a lot of people, there's glue everywhere. It's an absolute mess. You want to be clean with your glue. You want to have you don't want bumps and lumps and runs everywhere. This poor fella, his glue work was an absolute disgrace. So he didn't want to come over here and learn how to do it. So he's going to have to watch this video, I'm afraid, after he gets his arrows. But I'll do these ones for him just to show everybody. All right, we'll be back in a minute. Okay, here's the wrench. Just going to loosen that off. Here. And turn that more to the center. That's it. And then tighten that up. So it's slightly off. We'll see what kind of result we get with that. Make sure that one's cinched in. Yep. So now, when I put the clamp on, I'm going to make it dead level, because it's a helical clamp. So if I put it straight, it should just have a little bit of a turn in it. So I'm just going to make that, loosen that off, and put that on the dead center. That looks good. So got that center line there in line with that, and I'll just check that again. I'll put that on, and you can see it's going to have a little bit of a turn in it, but not as drastic as before. All right, so now here comes the trick. Scraping any excess off that I feel. If I feel any glue anywhere, we don't want that on there, especially on the insides. Especially on the insides there. Right, so I put the fletch in. and I'm going to line it up with the third mark there. Yep, so now I get the glue, I tip it up till it starts to run out. That's starting to run, and I just go across in an even stroke and let it up. Now I then tip it up like this, and any excess will, it's all covered down here now, but I'm going to get the excess coming off in the bottom like a drop. You see that starting to form there, see that? And what I do is I just touch that on the paper and get it off. So now there's none, and that's the exact amount now of glue that I require to put this on without making a mess. Put that in there, make sure it's got contact from the top and the bottom, and just leave that there for 30 seconds and that will set. I'll take it off, click it over, and do exactly the same thing for all three. Okay? Okay, once I get that out, I just use a tissue and just wipe away any excess glue. Shouldn't be much, but just down that way like that. Now, while I'm waiting for these to set, I'm going to start weighing. I'm going to get out the old Lyman, and I'm going to weigh all the points and put them in order from lightest to heaviest. So I'm going to do that while I'm waiting for the Fletchers to dry in between. Sort of maximize my time. So line that up. Where's that one there? It's ready to go. We'll get back to you in a second. Okay, I've got one in there. So I'm just going to show you what I'm doing over here with this thing. So turn it on. Fresh battery. Take out the calibration weight. Hold the calibration button down. Calibrate. Place that on there. Hit calibrate again. Right, the scale is calibrated, zero it. Now these are meant to be 120. 120.1. No, 2.2, hang on. 120.1. 120, all right. So just, it's probably just warming up. I'm just gonna zero that again. So I'm going to go through all these and put them in order while I wait for the glue to set on the shafts. I just always zero it first, place that on. So I go down here. What I'm doing down here is I place, there's a 1 and that's 0.2, so I place that one there like that until I have them all out, and then I can put them in order across this way. You can see that's what I've done here with my arrows. They're waiting to be at the points. But what I'm doing with mine is I'm using that Dremel over there. Do you see it on the sideboard there? That's the Dremel kit there. And I'm going to make sure that my arrows weigh exactly the same to within 0.1 of a grain. So they're ready to go. That's the point that belongs to each one. Lowest to highest, highest to lowest. But also, I will weigh them all and then I will just Dremel off a little bit of the tip, the point, to make sure that they're all exactly the same weight. And there's the cricket. So this is what we end up with when we weigh them. 0.1, 0.2 over 120, 120.3, 0.4, 0.5, 0.6, and 0.7. So there's a lot of, that's 6/10 of a grain between that and that in just your tip. So I'll weigh the arrows next and I will put them together with those. Heaviest arrow with the lightest, lightest arrow with the heaviest. And there's the arrows over there. Now what I'm going to do here is I will show you what to do, which is very important. Now, if you don't glue the back tips and the front, you're going to tear your fletch off. You're going to tear your fletch off as it goes into a target too deeply, or another arrow is going to hit that one there. Also, when you're pulling your arrows out, if you're pulling an arrow out and you hit this fletching, as you're pulling it out, it'll tear off the fletch as well. So you need to put a little dab of glue on each of those. So I'll just do that and give you an example of how that's done. You don't want a lot. Just a dab to seal the back like that. And I usually give it a tap on the ground, just a little tap. Get rid of any excess. And then if there's any up here, I just wipe that off because I only want it on the back point like that. Just to seal that back one. I'll do the backs first, or the top here. Do all of those. When that dries, I'll do all the bottoms. So to do the bottom of them, did a dab there, dab, just don't want too much, just to seal that point in. If I get too much, I just get a tissue and wipe between the veins like that if I do, but I didn't on that one. And that should keep them, yep, that's how to do this side here. So if you're pulling out and you hit them, if you get arrow contact the other way, they're much more likely to stay on. Well, I've only got three arrows to go. So while I'm waiting now for the arrows to be done, to fletch those last three, I'm going to start weighing the arrows. So unfortunately, it's gone off, so hit that, calibrate. Calibration is done, zero. And here's an example of weighing the arrow. So that's what we're looking at, 303.4. I don't know what the others are going to come out at, but that's a start. 303 will be around that region, 303.4. Now, 4 hours, okay. So now I've just got those, and those are all weighed. And now I'm going to get the lightest point with the heaviest arrow, etc. So I'll just show you putting one point in, and that'll be the end of it. Man, it's 20 to 1 in the morning, and I'm going to be at this tournament. I'm going to get up at 6 to go to this tournament tomorrow. All right then, bye-bye. Just, oh no, not bye-bye, but I'll just show you this one last thing, and then we're done. Right, man, I've had enough of this without a producer, I can tell you that. Trying to get the camera set up, turn this on. Heaviest arrow, lightest point. Going to use my fingers this time because I'm not going to heat it up that much. There's a bit more metal in this. It's not working though, man. It's getting too hot. Oh, now I've dropped the bloody thing. Suffering catfish. As you put it in, you just spin it around. Push it down. Wipe it around like that. And there you have it. There's a bit of excess on there. That'll, you can scrape that off when it comes clean, but that's it. That's your finished arrow. I don't want to have to look at these anymore, man. They are horrible to do with these terrible Fletchers, I tell you. A disaster. All right, well, there they are. Adios. I've had enough.